Time for the Molloy Drive Show podcast. Make every race this spring carnival even more exciting with Ladbrokes. Gamble responsibly. Call 1-800-858-858. Okay, Australia, you know him. You can count on him.
I'm a 50-50 chance.
You love him.
Hello. Go to the top shelf, ladies.
And now, it's his show.
Here we go, people.
This is Molloy.
Hello, Australia. Welcome to the Big Tuesday edition of Molloy. Hello, Dave.
How you going, Mickey?
Well, it's going to be a big one today. Limo swings by.
Oh, Limo.
Always happy to have a chat with the great Limo. One job. He's up and running. You're not going to believe it.
What's happened?
The Panda's failed again.
You're joking.
Wang, you had one
job. Oh, no.
We'll do the segment. We'll ask you to get involved.
Yes.
That'll be happening. What's happening on Facebook? What's happening on Instagram?
Oh, man.
Everything went down. Do you know what happened?
I've no idea.
Well, James Blake has a fair idea.
Yeah,
he's going to come in and talk us through it. And what I'm guessing is a bit of a nerd alert.
Okay.
We're going to take your calls. We'll take your tweets. Jackie Gillies.
Oh, Jackie Gillies.
From the Housewives of Melbourne, a friend of the show.
She is indeed.
Swing by. She's got a new podcast up. Lots to wade through, mate.
Sounds good. It's a Tuesday, so let's get things underway with a little
acca-dacca
here.
This is Molloy.
Attention. Attention.
Nerd alert.
The nerds are taking over.
What a nerd.
Time to sound the nerd alert.
Nerd alert. Nerd alert.
Well, it's a bit more than that today. It involves James Blake. Hi, James.
Hello.
But this is apocalyptic as well. It's also the world went into a state of panic. There was high consternation raging around the globe when Facebook, Instagram and WhatsApp went down, people, for 6 hours. James, was it 6 hours?
Yeah, now, lucky for us, that happened during the morning, but over in the US, it was prime time.
In the middle of the day.
So there was no way to share your photos, no way to reach out to your mates,
You have to wait 5 hours to send a dick pic.
Yeah.
I mean, come on. What kind of world are we living in?
It's quite grim. Facebook shares went down 4.8%. Zuckerberg's value went down $8.1 billion.
Oh, my God.
As a result. The office.
He's still got $160 billion, but $8.1 billion went down.
So this is incredible. Mm. And for a lot of people, I'm not being twee, they wouldn't have spent 6 hours in their life.
Yeah, that's true.
Off. People would have been panic stations out there. There would have been kids running around going, like, the sky's falling.
Yeah,
it's on fire.
Got to have a conversation with my family.
What can I do?
That's right.
I'm going to have to go and ride a bike. I have to do something.
It is really disconcerting to open up something like Instagram and just be presented with a white page and nothing. It throws you a little bit. It does.
Does it?
Yeah.
Right.
So what happened?
Yeah.
Okay. It looks like it was an internal error. To boil it right down, there was no way for the outside world to talk to Facebook's servers. So it looks like someone may have accidentally pushed the wrong button, sent the wrong update, and they've just taken down
all three. Someone's had a shocker. Someone at Facebook's had a shocker.
What,
a Homer Simpson moment.
Yeah.
Like, what does this button do? Doink.
Pouring water over the servers. So at one point, they actually had to send some really specialised technicians into the server farm.
Nerd alert! Nerd alert!
And do a manual reset, which is, you know, the technical way of saying turn it off and on again.
Right.
You know they should have sent in? The Fonz. he would have just punched it.
Yeah, or bang. An elbow.
We're back. There's no a suggestion of they were hacked.
Yeah.
Okay, well, the official line that Facebook is putting out is that no.
Right.
That everything is fine. But there's always a little bit of a concern, particularly the amount of data that they have. They've got our WhatsApp. They've got Facebook. They've got Instagram.
Where's the data? Is the data safe?
Apparently so.
Right.
That's what they're saying. Now, on a lighter note.
So I've got a few photos out there that really need to be.
Good to know.
OnlyFans and Uber Eats unaffected. They were left alone.
Phew.
That's
all right.
Yeah,
But they had to announce the fact that there was no Facebook on their rival Twitter as
on
well.
On Twitter. Twitter was absolutely. So Twitter.
This is pandemonium. This is the first sign of the apocalypse. What is going on? So you know who the big. You know who I feel sorry for?
Who's that?
And I conclude myself in this.
Mm. Oh.
Me and my brethren, the influencers.
Okay.
Because that's our livelihood. That's what we do. We post and we make money because we're hugely popular and we're massive celebrities.
Mm. It's the shop front.
It's the shop front.
Mm.
And if you take that down, you're taking food out of our mouths.
I am.
And, I mean, those people have worked really hard to get where they are. I mean, if Tammy Hembrow can't take a picture of herself on a beach in a bikini, what is the world?
Just a side note on that. I had her up on my Instagram before. Yeah. Mick grabbed my phone and was liking every photo and commenting like, whoa! So
I liked the photos, did
I? From my Instagram account. Anyway, so that's a lot of explaining.
By the way, just a little sidebar, guys. Should you... Like, I didn't realise everyone who follows you can go through your photos.
What do you mean?
Oh, boy. Yeah.
I didn't know that.
At any
moment. Why didn't anyone ever tell me that? Well, like, if someone follows you and you post, they can not only see what you're posting, but they can go, oh, I'll just get in there and have a look.
Of course they can.
And go through the whole backstory.
Right back to the start.
Yeah, well, that's information I could have used.
What's happened?
I'm just saying. Well, I don't know. The etiquette, when you say, James, you've got a new relationship and you've whatever, what do you do? Do you go and delete stuff or...
Personally, I do. I like to curate it a little bit.
So you go back and look through what you've had with previous relationships.
You lie.
Girls.
Be deceitful. Who you are, boozy and where you've come from.
I present what I want my story to be.
You're fluffing your own pillows. Cutting out the bad bits.
It's a bit like a museum. You don't need to have everything there.
My photo wall is 100% Mickey. What is going on in the world? Were you affected by this? 133353. I know from people out there has said if you were trying to sell something, send something, do anything, or your
forums, all that sort of stuff.
Stalk your neighbour. I mean, it just becomes hard.
How are you affected by
How were you affected by the greatest shock the world has experienced? People are saying we couldn't do this show if we...
Oh, James is banging on about, we have WhatsApp groups and stuff.
All right, well, to a peek behind the curtains, this show is organised by...
Nerd Alert! Nerd Alert!
We all have
Now you're peeking behind the curtains. On one stage, you're curating a
museum.
Yeah, we do. We do a lot of stuff.
There's our back-end producers WhatsApp, and then there's also the WhatsApp with Mick. And, it would have been hard to coordinate today's show if we didn't have WhatsApp.
And you have all my codes, don't you?
Because I do.
When I, in my phone, this he has true. Everything.
I've seen it in action.
He can order Uber Eats for me from his place.
He's got your credit card details. He's got your PIN numbers.
Passport, Medicare. I could book you
a
flight.
Why would you give someone all that information, by the way? What if things turn sour with you and James and all of a sudden he's got all your details?
Turn sour? 133353, were you involved? What happened? Come on.
Give us a call.
Driving you home, this is Malloy.
Jackie Gillies to join us soon and Limo in the second hour as well. We're all sort of coming to terms with the big outage today.
Unbelievable.
Big socials. We okay, guys?
The world... went mad for 6 hours. No Facebook, no Instagram, no WhatsApp.
Yep.
I mean, it was so hard. It was hard to show off to your friends.
Sure.
How am I going to take a photo of my breakfast?
It's so hard to get
everyone?
That misinformation on the vaccinations too.
Oh,
I mean,
that's right.
Terrible. You know,
I heard nothing from the anti-vaxxers. They're disconnected.
That's right.
This is incredible. Yeah. 6 hours. Whitney was saying that she got to work on time for the first time ever because she wasn't sitting there
scrolling,
swiping through
while she's driving too, which is a bad thing to do. Whitney,
that's what she does. All the time. I've told. How many times have we told her not to?
Terrible.
Do
that? She's got a new car as well, man. She's also
crashed the last one. Yeah. She was on Tinder
too much, swiping left.
Hey, Tinder, is Tinder up or down?
Okay, so Tinder is up, but there may have been some issues if you were trying to log into Tinder using Facebook. Then you might have had some issues getting into
Snapchat. Yeah.
Snapchat was fine.
TikTok?
I beg your pardon? What'd you call it?
TikTok.
TikTok.
What did I say?
You said TikTok.
TikTok.
that's my new one. That's one just for guys when we send TikToks to each other.
No one wants to
TikTok.
See that.
You want to get on TikTok.
Right,
okay. Be careful.
Yep.
Could have your eye out.
Ew.
Tinder good? Grindr Dave? What's happening there?
It was fine. What are you talking about?
You know what? I'm okay as long as the dark web's okay. Is the dark web up and running?
Oh, that'd
Thank
be always
God.
Okay. Yeah.
If I can't buy an AK.
Sure. All available.
Something. Yeah. All right, so here we go. Hey, Christian's on the line. Christian?
Oh, mate, what a heartbreak today was.
What happened to you? How'd you go? Did you get through the 6 hours?
Oh, mate, after 4 hours of hard work today, I couldn't sit on the concrete floor and watch my Facebook videos.
Oh, no.
Mate.
I mean, that's a lifestyle choice.
Yeah.
I've been in this industry for 6 years. This is the first day this has happened. Mate, Chris, treacherous.
Mate, you'll be right. We've just got to buckle up and get through this. Think of the influencers. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah, true.
They're doing it tough out there. Poor six things. Out. They've worked so hard.
They do.
Six, hey, Duke him, Dave.
A case of Brick Lane Draft. How's that sound for you, Christian? Nice and crispy cold for you?
Oh, thanks, mate.
Honest beautiful, way, mate. Mitch is on the line. Mitch, how did you get through it?
Yeah, Mick, Dad. Well, there's nothing to read for the whole of Smoko today.
Nothing.
What do you do? What do you do?
Forklift driver. So I'm on my arse anyway.
So you're a forklift driver. You go to Smoko, and there's no entertainment
what
for Smoko.
What am I
going
to do?
Dave Dukey.
No car chases to watch or, funny memes to look at. A case of Brick Lane Draft for you there, Mitch.
Beautiful.
All right, well done. There's a couple of other multimedia, social media questions for you. Did Instagram try and release a kid's?
Yeah, so they've just put the kibosh on it, but Facebook owns Instagram, was looking to develop Instagram for kids to see if there was a way to make like a safe little platform for them, which like just doesn't pass the sniff test when you think about, all right, you're going to make a single platform that is designed for kids. That opens it up for predators to go into.
Well, you're handing it to them on a platter.
Yeah, exactly. Here you go.
And you know what would be better?
What?
Tinder for kids. To set up play dates.
Right.
Hi, I've got a play date. Yeah, I want to set up a play date. Yeah. Who's where? Who lives in the suburb? Who's got kids? Oh, mate, write this down.
This is not bad.
Write this down.
There is Tinder for friends, according to Whitney. That's the thing.
Right.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Someone's already taken you.
Yeah. What's the point of that? It's just Tinder where people don't put out. That's what that is.
Are you on it?
Oh, isn't there I've never been on Tinder.
Isn't there like a celebrity one?
Celebrity one.
Is it Raya?
Yeah, it's Raya.
Can someone get me on that, please?
I think Warney might be playing in that space as well.
I'll double date with Warney.
Sure he is.
Anytime you like. Now, Tinder, you told me Tinder are doing, what are they doing?
So they're effectively going to be releasing coins like Tinder bucks, and these are going to be
Tinder dollars? That's like stripper dollars.
Yeah,
like,
it's a bit like Disneyland dollars, Disney dollars and all that kind of stuff. So it'll be things that allow you to do more super likes to promote your profile.
What's a super like?
It's sort of...
That's a stiffy. There's your super like.
It's like the digital equivalent of buying a woman a drink at a bar and saying, I'd really like to have a chat with
you.
So
now I don't even have to buy them a drink. I just buy them a digital drink.
You could just give them a super like.
Can you choose what you want? Can I have a digital Negroni?
I don't understand the Negroni. I don't know why you...
Mate, don't get... Okay. In that.
Sorry, you can just send him a simple super like. Unfortunately, though, like Whitney can attest to this, girls don't really like receiving super likes. It's a bit
super
creepy.
Likes.
Yeah.
What about looking through their bedroom window at night? Is that a no?
I think that's a big no.
I don't think that's kind
so. So you send a like, a super like,
yeah,
and then a stalky ear. A stalky emoji? I'm now stalking you.
Just peering through some curtains.
Yeah.
Well, there it is. It's all happening.
It's back on. That's the important thing. So we're all back to our normal lives again.
Just before we do, I'm setting up a GoFundMe page for the influencers.
Oh, are you?
Out there who were off air. That's their livelihood,
mate.
That is their livelihood. They've worked hard.
They have.
To get that up.
Taking photos.
And so we'll get a GoFundMe page for all those who, for 6 hours.
What a guy.
We're disconnected.
Thank you, Mick.
All in this together.
Yeah. All right.
No, well done. Well said. All right, this is Malloy on Triple M. Coming up, One Job, then Jackie Gillies.
Yeah. For the drive home, this is Malloy.
Coming up soon, Jackie Gillies is going to join us. Then it will be Limo in the second hour as well. Malloy, Triple M.
I have to mention another passing, Dave. Another showbiz passing. We were talking about Norm Macdonald
yesterday.
Maybe we need this regular segment, an obituary.
Obit. Yeah.
It's an obit. Do you ever read the obituaries?
I do. Yeah, I do generally. When it's like a big name or whatever, I like to see what the story is, background.
I always love that the openings, they'll have a opening sentence
that surmises
them.
Yes.
In a sentence. He was a community leader, captain of industry.
That's right.
With a history of philanthropy.
And then the story about their background and what they've done.
Have you ever wondered what that would be?
For me?
What about you? For me or for you? What would you want?
Oh, it's probably something like a 7-time Australian Commercial Radio Award nominee, never won, industry simpleton. Something along those lines, probably. What about you?
Guys wanted to be him, girls wanted to do him. He was a little firecracker. He was a little hottie. He went off like a firecracker in the sack.
Yeah. Okay.
That would be good.
Yeah, what else?
He was a comedian, entertainer, community leader, and had a giant wang.
You want that in the papers so
yes,
people can
I
read
do,
and
Dave.
Then read on. Okay.
All right. But you get the idea. But look, I bring it up because Alan Coulter,
yeah,
not a household name, but any fans of the David Letterman's The Late Show would know. He was the announcer. Mm. He did all the voiceovers for so long. He's died at 78. He was a long-running announcer. He was part of that show. You know, you'd recognise his voice immediately. You got it there, Dave?
Yeah.
From New York, the greatest city in the world, it's The Late Show with David Letterman. And now, king of unsocial media, David Letterman.
What a voice,
I have a visceral reaction to hearing that. It reminds me of every night I used to watch
sitting
that show.
Sitting down watching it. I'm with you.
And you knew it was game on when you heard Alan Coulter fire it up.
What a voice.
So he did all the intros, outros, guesting and stuff, but he also occasionally had his own segment, one of which was his Alan Coulter celebrity interview, which always went a bit pear-shaped. so after Letterman was finished with the guest, he was from his podium and he would dim the lights and come on and ask something, but it never went well.
All right. Here's Jessica.
Earlier tonight, Alan Coulter, our announcer, said, you know, Dave, you have some extra time tonight. I have something that I would like to do for the show. So, Alan, whatever it is you're up to, go ahead, take it away. It's all yours, my friend. Enjoy yourself. Alan Coulter, everybody.
You miserable, vindictive bastard.
What? I'm sorry. What? Excuse me? I'm sorry. What was that, Alan?
Don't play dumb with me, old man. Huh? You knew we were supposed to do another edition of Alan Coulter's celebrity interview tonight? Here, let me introduce you to my exclusive guest. Have you met Sarah Jessica Parker? Huh? Yeah, that's right. That's right. You just stole her so you wouldn't have to interview Jim Belushi for the millionth time.
I'm sorry, Alan.
Sorry, Alan. Look at her. I'm surprised she's still conscious after sitting there listening to your boring bull for 10 minutes. You know, it's bad enough. You come in here every day, you make your staff miserable, but only a grade-A ass would drag his guest into it. Am I right, Sarah? Am I right?
I'm uncomfortable.
Well, of course you're uncomfortable. We all are, working with that miserable lying.
Oh, that's outstanding. That's so good.
It is. So anyway, the sad passing died, 78, Alan Coulter. Of course, because I'm, once you're in those circles, because I'm a friend of Dave's.
Letterman?
Yeah.
What are you talking
about? He's talked about me on the show before. Did you have that there, Dave? Yeah,
our next guest is a very, very funny man, and he'll be performing, listen to this, with Australian comedy legends Glenn Robbins and also Mick Molloy. This will take place at the Adelaide Fringe Festival from February 19th.
That's pretty unreal as well.
That's the circles I mix
there, you're with the Letterman crew.
There it is. Okay, when we come back, it's one job.
Yeah.
Wang Wang Funyi, you've done it again. The window's closed. Hang about.
If you've got one job you want to chip into, 133353 is the number. It is Molloy on Triple M.
Get with the program, Toots. This is Molloy.
You had one job.
And you pinhead screwed it up!
One job it is, and we're leading off today. It's all in honour of the most disappointing pandas. And pandas are disappointing at the best of times, but these guys, Wang Wang and Funyi,
I know,
who just can't get it together.
What does it take?
They're both frigid.
Every year we talk about it,
we
get
go
our
through
hopes
this.
Up.
We try everything. They fly
Lane
guys
Benstead
out from China,
week.
You know.
That's right.
They've got
all the bells and whistles ready to go. They've got the
they
tree.
They play David Attenborough's voice in
right.
there. It's like porn.
What do you need? How can
get
we
off
help?
The bamboo, Wang Wang. Do your job. You had one job.
Not one job, exactly.
I mean, the window's tight, Dave. It's like a 48-hour window.
Which is ridiculous.
I'm telling you right now, if I knew that there was 48 hours of any given year...
To mate.
...that I could mate, seriously.
Yeah, no.
That's non-stop action.
Windows would be steaming up. No.
You'd have to try and put me down with a tranquilizer.
Really
bar. You'd have to send in the rodeo clown. Because I'm going, this is it.
Of course he would be.
You idiot, Wang Wang. They're still confident they can do it again.
Oh.
Yeah, right.
Is it just Wang Wang or is it Funi or is it like it's a, you know, it's not just one.
Well, see, I don't think she's helping.
That's what I mean. You can't blame it all on Wang Wang.
She seems to give him the silent treatment
really
a fair bit.
It does. That look.
Puts little, him off tap when he comes home.
A little sad face.
Yeah, not tonight.
Some bamboo.
I've got a panda headache. anyway, good luck to that lot.
That's not good.
Wouldn't it be great just to have a little panda?
Would have been very exciting. We could get behind something we need in these COVID times. We need some good news like that. That's bull. Unhappy about that.
Hold on, change their conditions. You know what I mean?
That's what I mean. What we've got to mix it up.
Put in a stripper pole. I don't know what you do, but something.
Bring in
has
another
to
panda to make that one jealous.
What, a threesome.
Well, wow. And I'm just saying, might make one
a bit,
jealous,
bit
and
of
then
panda action,
a little bit of
pandemonium. Okay, you had one job.
Yes.
Ron's on the line. Ron, who had one job?
Hey, Ron.
Ron?
Anthony at the Rugby League Grand Final.
What happened?
He hit the button a bit early.
Oh, Jonathan Thurston played the national anthem before Jonathan Thurston finished the Welcome to Country.
Oh,
that's right. One job to do here.
That is exactly right.
Mm.
You can't be doing that.
Nah.
Saw the first time there's been problems with the anthems at the footy. Do you remember the time they tried to play the the national anthem at AFL preliminary final? You've try and find it, Dave, and I'll keep talking. Yes. But that was another one. In the meantime, Duke Ron.
A case of Brick Lane Draft on its way for you, Ron.
Good on you. Yep, it was an awkward moment, no doubt. That was all that guy had to do was get that on time. Listen to this, Dave. Tarbes, a French soccer team, were this Saturday knocked out of the Coupe de France after they arrived at their match 50 minutes late. You know why?
Why?
The team bus had arrived on time, but 90 kilometres away because someone put in the wrong numbers to the GPS.
Oh, is that how it happened?
That's how it happens.
Oh, come on. Wrong coordinates.
Did you get the idea? Like, this is how much we don't trust ourselves anymore.
Yeah.
We'll get out the old mill ways and go, what is it? And I'll have a look at the map.
Idiots.
No, I'll just be spoon-fed by a computer. Garbage in, garbage out.
Get me a Gregory's. That's all I'm going to say. Bugger the GPS. Where's my mill ways? That's what I want.
The old mill ways.
Old school. Yeah, directory.
You know, in the old mill ways, I had a tattoo of mill ways.
What do you mean?
54 on my arm. So I had my house on it. So every time I got in a cab and I was drunk, I'd just point.
That's where I want to go. Yeah. Hey, you were talking about
the closest KFC.
You were talking about the anthems.
Yeah.
With some stuff ups at
stuff
football.
Stuff ups at football. It was a preliminary final. AFL.
Yep.
Tried to play the anthem. This happened.
Would you now please join with the players and the umpires as we stand for the Australian National Anthem.
See, the crowd loves it.
It should be the
of
national
course
anthem.
No one's unhappy about that at all.
Here's what I'm saying to you. Here's another good one, Dave. Suspects in an ATM attacks.
Mm.
Is there a criminal gang?
Mm.
They're in Europe,
right?
Holland, to be precise. And they go around bombing ATMs, blowing them up, taking the money.
Right.
Well, one guy was doing an instruction, like a TED talk, for the criminals on how to blow up an ATM.
Get your cash.
And he blew himself up on the video.
Like one job to do here.
To take him out or it's okay.
Yeah, no, he's cooked. But how funny is that?
Oh,
so,
yeah,
guys,
right.
This is what you got to
do.
This
is what you do.
And just make sure you don't connect the green wire with the red.
Boom!
You had one job.
It needs a funny sound effect under
it. It does.
You can put it on Funniest Home Videos. Dutch Funniest Home Videos.
Yeah.
A guy getting blown up with a boing.
I'd watch that.
Of course you would, Dave.
I'd do it. Yeah, I would.
133353. Come on, get on board.
Yes.
I've still got more. All but
right.
You, one job. Who stuffed it up? Might
get
be
involved.
Someone in your life.
A drive home that's always unpredictable. This is Malloy.
I don't like trouble unless I've caused it. Watch out, world, because I'm shining brighter than ever. Life is a journey, not a competition. Diamonds aren't a girl's best friend. Champagne is. I'm no fool, but I don't mind acting like one. Fake news I can handle. Fake people not in this life. Keep your standards high and your stilettos higher.
Wow. Those are pearls of wisdom you should write down and live your life by. That was like Yoda-like advice from the girls from the Housewives of Melbourne, which is back. And one of the stars, if not the brightest star, joins us now. Jackie Gillies, friend of the show.
Hey,
great,
Jackie.
Top chick. Husband, okay. Ben Gillies, of course. Pass on my best to him when you see him. Great to speak to you, Jackie. I haven't seen you in ages.
It feels so long. Do you know, when those intros came in and I saw that little cute little smirk that you just gave, that laugh, it's like, oh, my God, listen to these women and their taglines. I have to say, I think Roaches is the best. I don't like trouble unless I cause it.
Hey, I love it when the sparks fly. You know, when I'm flipping around, I cannot move past the Housewives of Melbourne. You lost a couple of big guns, Gina Liano and Lydia Scavello. There was always a bit of trouble coming from those quarters. Who can we expect trouble from in the new series?
I can confirm my bestie, Janet Roach, happens to be in the thick of it with a new housewife that she actually has known 10 years prior to coming onto this show. So that's going to be really interesting to see how that navigates.
Cannot wait.
So I think that people are actually going to enjoy this show because this season's a lot of humour, a lot of laughs. Yeah. With me personally, I show my IVF journey. I show my pregnancy.
Congratulations. You are carrying around twins.
Oh, Jackie, well
done. How about that?
Thanks, guys. Well, guess what? On season one and season three, I actually say I had a psychic prediction that I was going to have twins, and it's been recorded. Going through my IVF journey that I do talk about on my podcast, I had a dream. My grandmother came to me when I was going through the emotional ups and downs of IVF, and if anybody's experienced it knows, it is so challenging.
It's a tough
and
road.
I talk about this. It's so tough. And I actually had a dream. My grandmother came to me and said, you're going to have twins. And here we are with twins.
Hey, I wish you had a psychic prediction to tell me I was going to have twins. That might have come in handy at some stage. So how did you, when you found out you had twins, were you excited?
I actually knew. And what I mean by that is the day before I got the phone call from the doctors to say what your HCG levels were like, and I said to her, they're twins. And she goes, I can't confirm or deny that. I said, they're twins. I've already had a dream. It's definitely twins. And she goes, more than likely, Jackie, they are twins. Wow. And that was on the first day of finding out that I was pregnant. So, listen, Ben is so excited about it.
He'll be a great dad, by the way. He'll be the coolest dad in school by a mile.
He certainly will.
Some twins advice. I actually had triplets but lost one on the way home.
Oh, so, you are a piece of work. True, Jackie.
Twins, so buy them one present at Christmas and let them fight over it. No, you've got to learn. Life is tough.
I'm with you with that. I'm serious. Do you know what I actually said to Ben? A mate did this, and tell me if you've ever done this before. So he had two sons. One was playing up and one wasn't. Takes them to the cake shop. I'm not joking. Makes the other one sit there while the other one eats the pancakes and he's crying. Filming it on Instagram. And I went, that's legendary, because I can guarantee you that's how I'll be. If you aren't listening or taking note, I'm going to let the other one sit and eat the pancakes in front of you and you're going
to
learn.
Well, you can babysit my kids anytime you like. The other thing is, if you're going to send them to like a private school, only buy one school costume and send them on alternate days. So one of them goes and then writes down all the stuff and comes and tells the other one. And then the other
one save a bunch,
goes, if you're leaving them in the car, you need to leave two windows down about 6 inches. You know what I mean? Because there's two of them.
This is what I love, because you keep it 100.
Names? Have you got names?
We do, but I can't tell you.
Starsky and Hutch?
Something like that.
Hamish and Andy. Milo and Otis. Cagney and Lacey. Hey, tell us quickly. I bet we've got to go to your podcast.
Yeah.
What are you up
Shine
to?
It up.
This podcast is everything that I'm spirituality, manifestation, thought provoking, mindset, and what I'm up to. My IVF journey, being in a toxic relationship. I even give psychic vibes. And anybody that knows me, I mean, I've given you some psychic vibes over the years, Mick, and they've been pretty bloody accurate. There's some new ones coming in if you want one.
You were ahead of the curve. I had a couple of predictions. What have you got for me now? Anything? Be careful.
I reckon you're moving. I just got a psychic vibe that you're moving.
Moving where?
There's a new property, and I feel like you're looking. I can't wait to come to your housewarming party. Don't worry about that. I'll be there with the babies so you can babysit.
Jackie's all over it.
There you go. That's a little taste of what you can get on Shine It Up with Jackie Gillies.
It's available on all your favourite podcast platforms, everybody, and it really is inspirational. I keep it 100% real, and I talk about me losing a child before I fell pregnant.
Ep 1 and Ep 2 are up and about. Get involved. Thanks, Jackie, and good luck with Housewives of Melbourne.
Thank you, my loves.
Bye. Premieres October 10 on Foxtel, 8:30 p.m. It's Jackie Gillies. It's Malloy on Triple M.
For the drive home, this is Malloy.
Limo is going to join us in the
He's joining us right now, actually.
Oh, Limo's here.
Coming early. We say hello. Always a pleasure to have you on board, mate.
Wonderful to be here, guys. Hey, just going back to Wang Wang and Fu Ni, you were talking about before, the panda bears at Adelaide Zoo, who have refused to mate again. Exciting news, though, for Fu Ni. Shai can reveal here exclusively, she will be the next Bachelorette. So there's a bit of movement there at least.
Yeah, handing out the roses. Handing out the bamboo.
That's it.
Here it is. I like it. Hey, Limo, we've got Song Whisperer coming up, and then, of course, we'll have a chat in the next hour. Mm. Before we go there, though, we were talking about one job.
Yes.
And Bushy from Tatura's rang in. And Bushy, a farmer friend of yours, you reckon, had one job, yeah?
Well, he wasn't a friend, but a farmer that I was visiting at the time, he had one job, and he came down from Sydney, and the farm he just bought was overrun with rabbits. So when he came down from Sydney, I went out to the farm because I had to do a job for him, and he brought down a stick of dynamite.
Right.
Caught a rabbit, thinking the rabbit was going to run down the hole, but on its back.
Put the dynamite on the back of the rabbit, think it's going to run down a rabbit warren.
Mm. And the rabbit ran under his brand new Mercedes.
Is it? I mean, this has got Wile E. Coyote and Roadrunner written all over it, hasn't it?
It certainly has.
Bushy,
it was hilarious.
Has your mate...
But the rabbit... we're not condoning any violence against animals.
Has your mate heard of rabbit traps, Bushy?
That's just as vile, by the way. A rabbit trap is not much better than a better
stick
way
of
to
dynamite.
Go. But hang on, but if you've gone to the trouble of catching a rabbit and you've got the stick of dynamite and you think, I've got this plan, it's foolproof, as you light it and think it's getting a little, and it runs under your car.
Move the Mercedes.
That just blew the car up.
One job. All right, Duke him, Dave.
You've got yourself a case of Brick Lane Draft on its way to you in Tatura there. Bushy, good on you, mate.
Thanks
for calling.
We don't condone the violence, but the story, you know what it is? It's one of those karma stories.
Yes.
Yeah, where that's
the
exactly right.
Farmer got his just desserts.
Uh-huh.
Can I put it like that?
Yeah,
all
well
right,
said.
Dave.
Song Whisperer time.
Dave, the Song Whisperer. You're familiar with this. This is the segment Dave stole off Jay.
Well, Jay left.
It's never quite been the same, to be honest.
No, you're right with that.
it's like a drunk version.
Not it's quite as it cerebral,
it's
is it?
It's one of his two segments now. So we do a podcast of this show, and now you can also dial up something called Dave's Corner.
Sort of sort of piggybacking on Malloy. It's a spin-off, my little corner of the internet.
Okay. Is it like a philosophical corner?
We throw a few ideas around, a bit of that sort of stuff, you know.
Philosophical is probably
a bit generous.
You are more than welcome to join me for Dave's Corner anytime. That's an open invitation.
You're going
to
reveal his catchphrase today.
I'm coming up with a catchphrase. Because you know how it'll be on Dave's Corner today, but everyone's got a catchphrase.
That's what he does. He makes you dial it up.
Mick's got one.
He won't tell you now. Yeah.
You know,
clue, please.
Here's a synopsis. This song preaches the importance of being yourself. Share what's on your mind. Stop moaning about it and get on with it. Who's with me?
Be what you want to be. Do what you want to
be.
Yes.
That's not bad, actually. That's kind of working, but no, it's not that.
Trying to have a crack.
It's because you love me, wasn't it? Master's Apprentices.
I was trying
to think of the name of the song.
Do you want to go to a song? Do you want some thinking music?
I do. I need a bit of thinking.
Well, you can come back after the break.
Let's go with it. Give us the clue again.
All right. This song preaches the importance of being yourself. Share what's on your mind. Stop moaning and get on with it. Who's with me?
Friday on my mind.
No, not it. But if you do know, 133353.
Driving you home, this is Malloy. Time to gather back around your wireless, people. Here comes the big second hour of Malloy.
You're going to want to bottle this one, people. Limo is in the house. Yeah. No pressure, Limo. But we've been talking you up all day. We're going to take some calls as well.
I'm feeling good. We're coming off a long run today. Yeah. Can't wait. Oh,
we're going to have some fun. But before we get to the juicy bit,
let's
see if we can't sort out the Song Whisperer.
Whisperer.
You led them a merry dance recently, didn't you?
I have. I'm feeling pretty good about this one today. I think I might take the chockies again.
Well,
with the
don't
song.
Get ahead of yourself. Right, give us the synopsis, please.
This song preaches the importance of being yourself. Share what's on your mind. Stop moaning about it and get on with it. Who's with me?
Mm.
Yeah.
Okay.
133353. If you know, might win a prize, $200.
And who is?
Well, don't ask too many questions.
The importance of being yourself. So is it philosophical? Or?
Yeah, it's kind of just get on with it. Like, you know,
is it introspective? Is it saying?
Yeah.
Look inwards, not outwards.
Look inwards.
I think I know now.
What do you think?
Is it Divinals, Touch Myself?
Oh.
Okay, no, it's
Where did
that come from?
Is it this guy?
Oh, well, not this one.
Rah, rah, Rasputin, lover of the Russian.
It's not Rasputin.
It was a shame.
That's preaching the importance of being yourself.
Bob Catter.
I haven't heard that Boney M cover band before.
Share what's on your mind. Share what's on your mind. People do too much of that.
Oh, yeah.
Keep it to yourself.
I wish people wouldn't. What a gift it was earlier today when Facebook and Instagram were down.
What did you do for 6 hours? Nothing.
I had to actually have conversations with people. It was weird.
In a fetal position.
Yeah.
Share what's on your mind. No, don't. There's too much of that. Don't share. Bottle it up. Get angry. And then walk into, you know,
no, you've got to share your feelings. Get it out there and move on with life.
All right, let's go to the callers. Yeah. Colin's on the line. Colin, what are you thinking?
Hey, Colin.
I'm thinking Sydney Lauper. Girls just want to have fun.
Girls just want to have fun.
I don't know how you got there. Oh, yeah, I get it.
Yep.
Share what's on your mind. Stop moaning.
Not bad, but no, it's not. It's not a female performer, if I'll throw out a clue there. Think maybe.
And these guys probably would still be together if they hadn't shared so much of what was on their mind.
Possibly,
Whoa, what have I done?
You may have opened a can of worms.
What have I done? Too much?
No, you have almost given it away.
I've always ruined no almost segment. Look at him.
Ruined.
Wow. Huffy.
What about Gary? Where's Gary going?
Gary's on the line. Gary.
Mickey, Dangerous, and the great man, Anthony. How are you?
Very well, thanks, Gary.
Anthony. What is it, Gary? What are you thinking?
Look, I'm pretty sure I'm wrong, but this is just, I hope I'm right, just to really get you angry for the rest of the show, Mickey. I'm hoping that it's Tell Her About It from the Great Billy
Dump
Joel.
It, Dave. Dave.
Great song. From the Innocent Man record from 1983. By the way, Billy Joel, 50 years of Billy Joel. It's the 50th anniversary of his recording career. He's releasing some box sets. Hashtag 50 Billy, if you're interested.
Well, 50 years too long. That is.
If you watch Brooklyn Nine-Nine, the chief of police is a Billy Joel fan.
He is.
The most recent season.
Amazing.
A very good show. If you're looking for something to binge on Netflix, that's not a bad one.
Yeah.
No.
No, it's not Billy.
Duke him.
Case of Brick Lane draft for you there, Gary. Mm. Thanks for calling me, man. Appreciate it.
Chris is on the line.
Chris.
Chris, have a crack, mate.
Right, are you there?
Gotcha, mate. You're on air. What's your guess?
Well, Neil Diamond, I Am I Said.
Great song. It's my karaoke song.
Is it?
To no one there.
This is a good song.
Remind me to never go to karaoke.
You do love a bit of Neil Diamond,
don't
you?
You've been to a Neil Diamond concert, haven't you?
No, I haven't, actually.
You have not lived.
I do love a bit of Sweet Caroline, which is like a sporting anthem, oddly.
You've got to go there. We went there, and he released a new album called Lovescapes. Lovescapes.
You're a big fan?
Anyway, it was new. Yeah, it was the new stuff.
Yeah.
So anyway, we're at the tennis centre, and he's banging it out, and everyone's rocking. And then he goes, and now I'm going to do some stuff off my new album.
Oh, no.
And everyone just left. And everyone just left. So everyone's out in the bars drinking. And someone pops out and goes, he's done.
He's back off.
And then,
no one wants in your gear, Neil.
All right. Chris, have you said yes or no?
No, it's not Neil Diamond.
I like the sound of Chris Starr. I want you to do him.
Case of Brick Lane Draft coming for you, Chris, in Newcastle. Good to hear from you, mate. Appreciate that.
Aaron's on the line. Aaron, what are you thinking?
G'day, boys. How are you?
Good, man.
Good. What are you thinking?
Welcome.
I'm thinking Oasis, Roll With It.
Oh.
Roll With It.
Oh, yeah.
Say what you say.
Don't let anybody get in your way.
See what's on your mind. Stop learning. Get on with it. Roll with it.
Don't be denied. Be who you are. It's absolutely right. You got it right. Roll with it is right, Aaron. And you've got yourself $200 to go shopping at dshop.com.au. Do some D-Shop shopping today. Live better for less with D-Shop. Here they are. It's Oasis right now. Well done to you, Aaron. Well Limo's with us.
Driving you home, this is Malloy.
In studio by Limo.
What have you been up to, buddy?
Gladys Berejiklian, of course, is no longer Premier of New South Wales. Yeah. Would she be on a Mad Monday today? Would she, would she be with the Panthers somewhere?
With Panthers and Gladys in adjoining rooms. I don't know, what do you do as a politician when you...
Is she smashing a yard glass out there somewhere?
I would hope so.
Or is she with the Rabbitohs?
Well, she can because she lives in Sydney. You wouldn't get away with it in Melbourne.
You wouldn't get away with it. I mean, what the state of this country at the moment. Yeah. We've got Gladys stepping down amid corruption charges.
Yeah.
ScoMo's having a crack at everyone. It is an absolute shit show at the moment. There are people in Afghanistan at the moment looking at us going, whoa, what a mess. Wouldn't want to go there.
Those guys are in trouble.
Yeah. But Gladys, right?
Yes.
Steps down amid corruption charges. Amid corruption charges. And gets carried shoulder high from the room. Here's some of the stuff that's been said about her. Oh, she gets things done. She's a strong presence. She's a good friend. She's trusted, respected. ScoMo said she's doing the best for the people of New South Wales. The allegations are that she spent their money. And then Daniel Andrews, even the bloody Labor Party's on board. He comes out and said she had great integrity.
Right.
Politicians are the worst. I used to think boxing was corrupt. I would trust Don King ahead of this one. She oversaw a grant.
Well, nothing's been proven yet.
Let the inquiry.
Well, we know this for a fact. She oversaw a grant of $5.5 million to Clay Pigeon Shooting Australia.
Well, that had to be done.
Do you want to know how that went? I'll tell you how that went. Do you want to know where we came at the Tokyo Olympics? 21st! 21st! A bloke from the Czech Republic won gold. You reckon he had $5.5 million bucks behind him? A 57-year-old Kuwaiti won bronze. Did he have $5.5 million bucks? Give me $5.5 million, I'll get you a bloody podium in Paris.
Clay shooting, how much?
$5.5 million bucks to clay shooting in Wagga.
Right.
That is the national debt of Wagga. Hey, can you hang around, Lee?
Yes.
I want you to hang around.
Yes.
I know we've got you for a bit. We're going to take some calls.
Yes.
Well,
I have to out my wife for something.
All
right, Limo's with us. More coming up.
A drive home that's pretty loose. This is Malloy.
Yes, Limo is with us in studio. You are listening to Malloy.
How's things at home, Limo? You happy?
Oh, yeah. We're
all good. Got a beautiful wife and child.
Yeah.
And are you seeing a lot of them, obviously?
Am I ever? I had on the Friday before Father's Day, I was talking to...
Actually, it's not a wife, so I should point out.
The fake marriage.
You had a fake wedding, which you took me to.
I was talking to a friend who's not in lockdown.
Yeah.
And he said, what are you doing? This is a month ago. He said, what are you doing for Father's Day? And I said, I'm just going to spend the day at home with my wife and my son. And he said, in all seriousness, nice to spend a day with your family. I said, is it?
Is it though?
Is it? But they're going all right. Kel came to me one day, looked me in the eye and said, we need to start seeing other people.
Literally.
We just need to see other people. But I'm going to out her here because she rang me, it was about a week ago. She rings me in a flap, right?
Yeah.
I said, what's going on? What's your problem? She said, how do you open the petrol tank on the car? Where's the thing? And I said, well, it's down by your right knee. Mm. You just pull the clip back and it pops the petrol tank thing.
Yep,
and she's looking for it and she's getting all grumpy and she hangs up the phone so she can't find it. Anyway, and then I get off the phone. I think to myself, we bought this car 12 months ago.
Right.
She has not put petrol in it once.
Never.
In 12 months.
This is an interesting idea.
I said, are you joking me? For 12 months you've avoided. And she said, yeah, I just don't like putting petrol in the car. I said, well, neither do I, but you have to do it. Someone's going to put petrol in it.
So she would run it down and then make sure you were in.
Yeah.
at the wheel, at the controls,
when it needs re. So I got in it this morning, and the red light's flashing when I get in.
Jane Kennedy was smart for this. How many times we had to go and pick her car up once?
She ran out of petrol.
She would run it down to the red, down to the red, and same thing, just doesn't like, and not her thing.
No, and James had to get a jerry can to go fill up and put in her car in the car park. It's happened a few times.
And I had an ex-girlfriend of mine who ran out of petrol, I reckon. I dated her for a year. I reckon four times she ran out of petrol. I said, why don't you?
Yeah.
She said, I'm just trying to get rid of the... She said, I'm trying to get rid of the bad petrol at the bottom of the tank.
Oh, come on.
Apparently there's bad petrol.
No, it's no good for your motor.
And why do you think it is? Have you got a theory?
I think it's a male-female thing, no doubt about it.
It's an outdoor thing, so it's like barbecuing or something. That's an outdoor thing, you do it.
Yes. Let's conduct a little survey on 133353. Women, fess up if it's you. If you don't like refuelling, tell us why.
Yep.
And tell us how long it is since you've refuelled. And blokes, feel free to dob your partner in. 133353.
Before we go to that, I just wanted to say, do you know when the downfall of the petrol station was self-service? And this is where women will go.
Yes.
And I remember this was the start of it. This is why now banks are out on streets and all this stuff. They say, no, it's going to be a better service for you. And actually, it's not.
Mm.
So when the self-service was brought in, and you can remember, there used to be a guy with overalls and a rag in his pocket. Who'd come out, put it in, he'd do your windscreen, he'd check your radiator, he'd do all that. And they went, no, we're going to change it. But what it's going to realise is it's going to be cheaper petrol.
Oh, of course.
So
bring
you
the prices
get out,
down.
You do our job, and then you give us the money for doing our job, and you get in the car and you drive off. And you know what? Petrol prices never went down.
No, they never went down. It's a business model, though. I'll tell you what, you put a bloke who's half a spunk at a petrol station near us, my wife will be down there when it's three quarters full.
Right.
Just whacking a quarter of a tank in to say good day to that bloke.
Banks go, look, we'll put the ATM out the front.
Yes.
And you know what it'll be? Lower fees.
Yeah, right.
Bullshit.
Never happened.
We've got you where we want you, out on the street. 133353, what's going on?
Yeah.
Filling up a tank of fuel, girls. Let's go.
This is Malloy.
It's a men versus women kind of debate here, right? Limo,
we're trying to get to the bottom of it, aren't we?
Yeah, my wife refuses to refuel the car, and I busted her refueling it we've had it for 12 months. She refueled it for the first time last week. I say it's a male female thing, and I'm saying women. Give us a call. 133.
What do you think it is? They don't like getting out of the car.
I don't.
It's the petrol smell.
Well, we want them to explain this to us very shortly. And fellas, we're asking you to out your partner as well.
What's happening? We want to know the lie on the land. We're taking the temperature. What's going on out there? Anne's on the line. Anne, what are you thinking?
I don't do the fuel as far as my.
And is that a philosophy? It's just we went, not my department.
Yeah, no, I do enough. I clean the toilet. He can do the fuel.
Fair enough. Makes a good point.
Fair enough. Yeah. We should get some papers drawn up here. It's like that should have been in a prenup.
Absolutely.
And it works for you?
For sure. I'm in Wangaratta, so we mainly have an ABCO. And to me, ABCO is just for donuts and drinks.
for me, donuts, drinks, and like light porn.
Yeah,
you know those magazines in plastic.
The picture magazine. That's right.
What about having a picture magazine? Picture and people. Remember those?
Girls.
I used to go in Big M.
Yes.
Go papers and yoink.
I get
picture people.
Yeah, I think the internet might have killed picture and people magazine. Bromwen, is it a male female thing?
It's my husband. I'm the one that fills it, and he's the one that empties it.
No kidding.
He stands for enough. And when there is no petrol to start the car, he goes and gets the bloody jerry can for the lawnmower and takes it out of that.
Ron.
Jeez. Hey, Ron, you've got a bum on your hands there.
Yeah, that's right.
And why doesn't he fill the petrol? What's his thing?
He just never has. He just thinks he's for enough, and that's just the way it is.
Pardon me, Your Majesty. He just runs around and chucks you the keys, does he? Honey, fill up the tank, please.
Is he at least pulling his weight around the house, Bronwyn?
Yeah.
Yes, he does. He does do that, but just the petrol thing is just not happening.
I want you to duke, Bronwyn.
I've got $100 worth of grilled coming your way. The HSC Pocket Rockets have landed. They're amazing. Grill.com.au.
Thanks so much.
Yeah, have some dinner on us. Well done, Bronwyn. Like it.
Our pleasure.
Yeah.
Jono is on the line. Jono, what are you thinking?
Yeah, g'day, guys. My missus keeps saying that she's too short to see over the steering wheel, to see the fuel gauge.
Oh, stop it.
And then I ask her how she's telling how fast she's going, and she says, just on the heads-up display, right next to the heads-up display, it says you need fuel.
Well.
Right. How does she see the road?
Yeah, it's a bit concerning.
Yeah, I don't know either, mate.
Who are you married to? Mrs. Magoo. Now, here's what you invest in, a couple of phone books.
Yeah.
And she's away, Jono. Thanks for the call. Luke's on the line. Luke?
Yeah, mate. Yeah, it's not just a women thing, mate. I broke down on the Westgate Freeway just because I could not be bothered putting more fuel in the car. And I don't even pay for it. It's a work card. It's all motor parts.
Right. And how are you feeling about your decision to not refuel it when you broke down on the freeway, Luke?
Yeah, pretty bad, mate. And the RACV guy calls and they said, oh, because of COVID, you can't get in the cab. And I said, you've got to be kidding me.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, have to hand in the man card after that.
Good stuff. Do you know, there's this story about Gary Ablett Sr.
Mm. Oh, yes.
And
yes.
He was, because... you know, he was in Geelong, a trucking company sponsored him, right. And they gave him a job outside and they gave him a truck,
yeah.
And he was just
driving
a truck.
Gary
anyway, one day they just saw the truck that they'd given him abandoned on the side of the road.
What happened?
And someone went back and goes, did anyone know what Gary's doing that? Someone said, Gary, what happened to the truck? He goes, I ran out of petrol.
He just left it.
He just walked away.
He walked away
and never returned.
And I believe he hitchhiked back to Geelong.
That's amazing.
Good stuff.
He got someone gave him a sit-down lawnmower to do the lawn.
Wow.
Because he hadn't done, it was a bit of a, mate, you might want to do your lawn. So he got a sit-down lawnmower. Mm. And anyway, someone saw him 5Ks from home on the sit-down lawnmower. He goes, what do you do? He goes, I'm going to the shops.
On the road. Just travelling on the road.
I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to take a break and come back and take some more.
Yeah, we can do that.
Yes.
Yep, right
yes,
after this.
A drive home that's always unpredictable. This is Malloy.
It is. Limo still with us. This has been great. Taking your calls, 1-3-3-5-3.
Phones have blown up. We're asking you, what is the question, Limo?
Well, why do women hate refuelling the car?
It seems to be a job that men... Do.
Is it a thing? Let's go to Perry in Launceston. Is it a thing, Perry?
It's a thing, but unfortunately not my wife, it's me. And the worst example of it would be our firstborn child. I was at work and my sister-in-law had to pick my wife up. They got in the car 100 metres down the road from the hospital. The car runs out of petrol on the way home.
Oh, my God, oh, no, Perry.
You have had a pain.
And, you are
and it wasn't a simple matter of walking home. She'd had a caesarean. So,
Perry, you've had a shocker. You have had a shocker. How was the mood?
Yeah, what was the temperature?
When everyone got home?
Yes, very salty, but it was a good memory because my sister-in-law took a photo of the empty fuel gauge.
Yeah.
She had it then printed onto a T-shirt. And gave it to me for Christmas, and I've still got it 15 years later.
Well played, sir.
There you go.
$100 worth of grilled coming your way as well, thanks to grill.com.au. Well done, Perry.
For the final word, Louisa, tell us, what is it? What is it about women? Why don't you like filling it up?
I just hate stopping on my way home. I won't stop at the petrol station. I won't stop at the shops. I won't stop anywhere. I just want to keep going like an arrow.
You realise the car will stop itself,
that's
Louisa.
Right. You've got some point.
Well, apart from when I'm
home. Coming home from work's like a Thelma and Louise style road trip for Louisa. Give her something, Dave.
We've got, I tell you, we'll get some grilled for you as well. Yeah. Well, I'll dig into the prize cupboard here. The HSC Pocket Rockers have landed, so here's some dinner.
All right.
Thanks, Louisa,
good
so
stuff.
Much. Well done, Limo. Thanks for joining us today.
What have you got to plug?
Yeah.
Thank you, team. I'll just be on Zoom by myself. Anyone, call me.
All right.
Hang in there, mate. We're nearly done. We'll see you soon.
Thank you, team.
We'll go have a beer in a pub someday.
Oh, yeah. That'd be
remember
nice.
That? Remember
that'd be
that?
Nice.
Old days.
Yes.
Oh, it's Malloy on Triple M.
Get with the program, Toots. This is Malloy.
It's all thanks to Ladbrokes, and you can Ladbroke at this spring carnival. Gamble responsibly. 1-800-858-858.
Ladbroke it to the billio, people. It's your time to shine.
It is
spring carnival. It means one thing.
Mm.
The GGs are going
back
around.
Out.
What's the big race this Saturday, Dave?
You got your Caulfield Guineas this weekend.
We're straight into it.
Yeah, that's right. Spring racing carnival.
You need to be going there fully armed, fully aware of the greatest app ever delivered for the punters involved in racing.
No other.
It's Ladbrokes.
Yes.
They've done all the heavy lifting for you. And guess what, Dave?
Tell me.
This is their fastest their app has ever been.
Is
You've
that
got to
right?
get the update.
So the engineers have been in the lab. Update. They're making it as quick as they possibly can.
They should get the guys who did this to Facebook.
Yes.
Those idiots went down for 5 hours.
100%.
Facebook, Instagram, you're mucking around.
Ring the Ladbrokes people.
End.
They'll get it back up. The world will be moving again.
Should have just called the good folk at Ladbrokes. They would have tooled around and got
That's
it up.
Right.
They are the best in the business.
No doubt.
It's like you're in the future.
Exactly right. Well, here's the thing too. As part of one of the great things, features they have on the apps is the same race multi.
I love the same race multi.
So they're making every race this spring carnival even more exciting. So same
you get back horses to finish in different positions.
That's right. Yeah,
that's
yeah. Right. In the same race, so a potential bigger payout.
So I can back a winner. I can say I want this one number three, yeah. And someone to come last.
Maybe the last one.
Oh, can I do that?
Well, yeah, well, that, sure that
could,
you can.
That could be open to. Well, yeah. Betting.
Oh, I guess if the horse is coming last, but, you know, put it in your multi, see how you go.
Can I back Chautauqua not to come out of the stalls?
Got form. It's happened before.
They're off. Now I'm looking for Chautauqua, and I can't find him. He hasn't jumped. Chautauqua hasn't jumped.
Oh, bless Chautauqua. I wonder how Chautauqua's going, by the way.
I wouldn't ask if I was you.
Really
how
well
good is spring?
It's the best.
If we could just get all those jockeys out of that Airbnb on the peninsula
right.
And get them to the track, this could be the greatest spring. Imagine how much fun you're going to have. You've been cooped up. You've
this
been locked up.
Yeah, that's right.
What's the opposite of that?
Having fun.
Going to the races, mm-hmm. Dressing up, being social, yep. Being around
back
other people, having
again.
A shared experience.
That's right.
And in your hand,
yeah.
You have the keys to a fortune.
Amazing.
All Ladbrokes, you're the best in the business.
They
you
are.
Know it. I know it. Getting bored.
All right, Ladbrokes. Ladbroke at this spring carnival. Gamble responsibly. Call 1-800-858-858. It's Malloy on Triple M.
A drive home that's always unpredictable. This is Malloy.
Done and dusted.
Done and dusted. Full as a gourd.
Full as a gourd.
Hello,
like.
Girls. Dinner's on.
Yeah, yeah.
Boom shakalaka.
Mickey.
That's one.
Yeah, you've got a bunch, don't you?
I do.
As I mentioned in my podcast last night, Dave's Corner,
yes,
episode 18, been coming up with a new catchphrase.
Well, and it's unveiled today.
In the corner, yeah. So
on
I won't,
Dave's Corner.
Won't do it
don't
yet.
Do it now.
No, I won't do it now. But
don't do it now.
My new cat. Oh, you're right. What is that?
This is unbelievable. So we are a radio
broadcasting
station.
Yeah, that's right.
One of the biggest in the country.
Biggest networks.
So we put in all like soundproofing.
These studios will be worth millions of dollars.
Have a listen to a seat. Oh, yeah, everybody. Hey, Dave, why don't you move your microphone?
Yeah, listen to this.
Here it is. Can a WD-40 to the studio, please?
Very unprofessional.
Crazy stuff.
Very
crazy stuff.
Hey, that's it for the show today. Tomorrow on the show, you know, we've been watching on 7 Mate, Australia's Sexiest Tradie.
I love it.
Frankie Wood.
He's back.
He's going to be back on the show tomorrow.
He got a bit ripe last time.
He got very ripe. And if you watch the show, you're going to love him being on the radio tomorrow. So Frankie
great.
Wood, Merrick Watts will be joining us as well. That's it for Dave's Corner. Yeehaw! Back to drive you home tomorrow.
What was that?
Triple M. Nothing.
This has been the Malloy Drive Show podcast. Putting a bet on with Ladbrokes is as fast as tap, tap, boom. Gamble responsibly. Call 1-800-858-858.